Hi guys, this is our next video. It is a continuation of the overall review about our subject heat and mass transfer. In this video, we will be having a review about Unit 3, that is phase change heat transfer and heat exchangers. First, we have to know what is phase change heat transfer. Wherever there is a heat transfer along with the phase change, that is, if a liquid is changed to an vapor or a vapor is changed to a liquid, then it is called as phase change heat transfer. And also about heat exchangers. Heat exchangers are used to exchange heat from a hot fluid to the cool fluid. For example, they are used in power plants and also in our radiator, in many of the IC engines, in many parts of IC engines. First thing, pool boiling. What is defined as pool boiling? A pool boiling is a phenomena where heat is transferred from a submerged solid to a liquid. That is called as pool boiling. Pool boiling has three regimes, that they are natural convection, nucleate boiling and film boiling. We have to find out which type of boiling, which type of regime is happening in the given process. If the temperature difference del T value is less than 2 to 3 degrees Celsius, then it is natural convection. And if the del T value is about 5 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius, it is known as nucleate boiling. And if it is above 10 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Celsius, then it is known as film boiling. Then the next topic is condensation. We know that condensation is a process of transfer of a fluid into liquid. That is known as condensation. Both the formulas for boiling and condensation are available in our data book. The important thing which we have to note down is, while using those formulas, we have to convert each and every property in its basic units. That is, if a temperature is given, then it is should be substituted in Kelvin, not in degree Celsius. If a value is given in kilojoule, then it has to be transferred to joule. If you substitute it in kilojoule, then the whole answer will be wrong. And what are the, how to find the difference between a problem which is boiling or condensation? In boiling, the surface temperature will be greater than the saturation temperature of the liquid given. But whereas in condensation, the surface temperature will be lesser than the temperature of the gas, surface temperature of the gas, so that the condensation occurs. Okay. Since all the formulas are detailedly given or detailed in our HMT, heat and mass transfer data book, I have not once again reviewed the formulas. So now, the next topic in the third unit is heat exchangers. Heat exchangers is of three types, that is parallel flow heat exchanger, counter flow heat exchanger and cross flow heat exchanger. Mainly the problems will be asked to problems are used to compare the parallel flow heat exchanger with the counter flow heat exchangers. First we have to know what is parallel flow heat exchanger and what is counter flow heat exchanger. If both the hot fluid and the cold fluid inlet are on the same side or on the same direction, then it is parallel flow heat exchanger. And if it is in the opposite side or opposite direction, then it is known as counter flow heat exchanger. And if one of the fluid flow is 90 degree perpendicular to the other fluid flow, then it is known as cross flow heat exchangers. The effectiveness of the heat exchanger is maximum in counter flow type. Cross flow type. And if we compare parallel flow with counter flow, it will be greater in counter flow heat exchangers. The important points we should remember is, if any of the three temperatures are given, then we can solve the problem in an LMTD method, that is logarithmic mean temperature difference method. The four temperatures that we have to find out is hot fluid temperature inlet and outlet, cold fluid temperature inlet and outlet. If any three of them are given, then we can use LMTD method. If only two temperatures are given, then there is no other choice. We have to go for NTU method. And if either any of the method is specified in the given question, for example, if three temperatures are given and also the question in the question it is specified as use NTU method to solve, that is number of transfer units methods to solve the problem, then we have to use NTU method only. We should not use LMTD method. Possible questions that can be asked are heat transfer Q. We know that Q is equal to HALT or MCPLT. Both the formulas can be used. Any one of the temperature can be asked. If it is an NTU method, any one of the temperatures can be asked. Area of the heat exchanger, the last, if you use Q is equal to HALT, the area can be asked. And also effectiveness. Effectiveness can be calculated from the graph. And NTU value, number of transfer units value, and also the number of tubes or number of passes can be asked. If any three temperatures are given, then the fourth temperature has to be found out by the formula Q is equal to MCP delta. That is, Q hot fluid will be equal to Q cold fluid. We assume that the total heat loss by the hot fluid is equal to the heat gain by the cold fluid. So the Q value will be equal in both the cases, that is hot fluid and cold fluid. So Q hot fluid will always be equal to Q cold fluid. If you use Q hot fluid, Q is equal to MCP delta, that is capital T2 minus capital T1 minus capital T2 is equal to Q MCP small T2 minus small T1. The unknown temperature can be easily found out. This is how we will be finding out the fourth temperature in an LMTD method. This formula cannot be used in NTU method. How would we solve the NTU method problems? For NTU method problems, first we have to find out MC multiplied by CC, that is specific heat of the given fluid, mass flow rate into specific heat. That is known as capacity rate. Which capacity rate is lower, the corresponding formula has to be taken and the corresponding values can be substituted and the NTU value can be found out. Once the NTU value is found out, then we have to refer the graph and find out the effectiveness. Once the effectiveness is found out, then we have to find the Q value. Okay. And the last topic is fouling factors. What is meant by fouling? In all the heat exchangers, a fluid is used. We all know that heat exchangers will be maximum made by metals. And the basic tendency of a metal over a prolonged period when it is exposed to a fluid, it may carry rust or some scales. This always decreases the effectiveness or the efficiency of the heat exchanger and also the heat transfer rate. So, and fouling factor, that process is known as fouling, and a fouling factor has to be considered. The fouling factor will be considered based on the conductivity, temperature, and also the life of the material used. This is all from the third unit. We will be having an overall review of the fourth unit in our next video. Thank you.